I think the single most important aspect of tunnelling is obviously having a work plan, and the elements to that are drawing up a work plan that can be executed, identifying the risks involved with that and mitigating them, and then obviously communicating that plan to the guys that are going to carry it out, and revisiting it on a daily basis if necessary, or on a regular basis, you know, because things are going to change. So it's important that you identify the changes as they're coming up and revise the plan to suit, and again communicate. In actual fact, the word communication was the first word I basically learnt in, you know, the first job that I was on. In the I remember the agent coming up to me saying communication, and it's true.
Communication in the tunnel is achieved by many different sources. These sources can be verbal, electronic, or nonverbal, such as signage, hand signals, or lighting signals. These communication signals can be used for a variety of messaging. These messages may include evacuation, traffic control, Loki signaling, or crane signaling. The leaky feeder is a hard line wired throughout the tunnel that works as an antenna for handheld radios to transmit. Using this form of communication allows someone to broadcast throughout the tunnel by means of handheld radios. Flashlight signals are generally used for calling the Loki into or out of an area. Always use the heading as your reference point. There are three basic flashlight signals used in the tunnel. The light moving in a circular motion signals the Loki towards you. The light moving up and down signals the Loki away from you. And the light moving side to side signals the Loki to stop.
The way we communicate in the tunnels, we have mind phones set up. It's a two-way line that we can use. These are set up throughout the tunnel, different areas of the tunnel, problem areas we might have, areas where there's equipment staged, maybe transformers, VF drives, boosters for your conveyor, cross pass areas. Anything like that, we'll have mind phones set up in these areas. Runs on a single line. If I'm on it, you can pick up any phone in the network and you can hear exactly what I'm saying, and they can cut in and talk as well. That's the communication system that we use throughout the tunnel industry.
Mind phones are hardwired phones with receivers placed at regular intervals. They act as a party line system that allows workers to broadcast messages throughout the entire tunnel and on the surface. This system is designed to reach all areas of the project at once. To operate the mind phone, just pick up the receiver, push the button located on the receiver, and activate the toggle switch simultaneously. This will allow the message to be broadcast across the site. If this is a general message that requires communication to everyone, you would continue to hold the toggle switch while pushing the button on the phone and talking into the receiver. If you want to speak to a specific area or worker, repeat the instructions above and stay on the line. The person or area that you are calling will use the receiver to talk to you. To only talk to each other and not broadcast throughout the tunnel, only push the button on the phone when talking. Releasing the button allows the other person to speak back to you, repeating the same procedure. When you are finished, you just hang up the handset. Evacuation signaling is for emergency situations only and should be done by broadcasting over the mind phone to all areas. In case of an emergency, directions shall be given to all areas as to the nature of the emergency or evacuation order, and workers and visitors shall be told where to proceed and what actions to take. Light signals are colored lights used on trailing gear, Lokis, or the segment erector, and can be used in addition to flashlight signals. These will be used in conjunction with retroreflective tape. In addition, audible systems on trailing gear may be used on some projects as well. Traffic communications and traffic control consists of operations both above and below ground. It is important to be reminded of the flow of traffic and materials on the job site. Generally, most tunneling jobs will have a specific traffic control plan that addresses the coordinated movement of equipment, materials, and vehicles on the site. Top and bottom lander communication. The top and bottom lander controls what is allowed down into the tunnel. The top lander is the ultimate person responsible for allowing anything below. As a load is lowered down, control is switched to the bottom lander. Depending on the depth of the shaft, the point at which control is passed between the top and bottom may vary. Each site will determine the appropriate procedure for working out this communication. Stickers are used to identify materials that are in the specific piping systems. Piping in the tunnel usually carries water, air, grout, bentonite, or slurry. Each pipe is clearly marked with what substance is inside and the direction of travel for the materials.